Does your company have non-taxable customers or even non-taxable products or services? Well, then you need to learn how to record non-taxable customers and products. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. Some customers or clients may be exempt from our requirement to charge and collect sales tax. There could be many reasons for that. Some products or services we sell may also be non-taxable. You must check the rules from your own state's tax department in order to determine who may be eligible for non-taxable sales and which products or services you may indicate as non-taxable for sales tax purposes. For example, let's imagine that apples are now non-taxable for sales in Massachusetts. Well, that's very simple. We would have to open the list of products and services and change the status from taxable to non-taxable for that specific item. We click the cog wheel and go over to Products and Services. Now we select apples by going to the row of apples and clicking Edit. And if you scroll all the way down where it says Sales Tax Category, you can choose Non-Taxable. And then you click Save and Close. And now watch what happens in our example. Let's imagine on June 18th of 2020, we sold 2 apples and 1 banana to Betty. The payment was directly deposited into your bank account, which means this time we're going to make a sale receipt instead of an invoice. So what will be the result in the trial balance after we record this sale receipt? Well, we know the gross sales will increase by $1,200 because one banana is $1,000 and 2 apples are $200. However, the tax will only be based on the $1,000 banana, and that's why the Massachusetts sales tax will only increase by 6.25% of the price of the banana, because only the banana is taxable. So even though the wholesale is $1,200, the tax is only $62.50. And of course, the cash in the bank would increase by the entire amount, $1,262.50, the sales price of everything, plus the eligible tax. Let's take a look how to record this sale receipt. In the top left, we click New, and we go down to Sale Receipt. Now we choose the customer, Betty Boop. And of course, we put the date. You have to go back to June 18th of 2020 in order to make this work. And we go down to the products and service. When we choose apples, look what happens when we choose apples. Nothing. But look what happens when we choose bananas. Same thing. Let's make the quantity of apples become 2. Now watch. If we click the check mark next to apples, no tax is calculated in the bottom right. But if we click the taxable check mark next to bananas, you can see that after we go down and click see the math, oop, that's a little explanation popping up that we can close. But you actually have to click see the math after you apply the tax. Now again, watch. The tax, as you can see, is $62.50, which is 6.25% of only the bananas, not the apples. And again, if I remove the taxable from the apples and click see the math to recalculate, nothing happens. But if I put that back and I remove the tax from the bananas and again click see the math, you see then the tax is removed. The tax only shows up when I choose the check mark next to the bananas and click see the math and then close the explanation. So that proves that even if it's checked off as taxable, it will not add to the sales tax as part of the transaction because we have already set apples to be non-taxable in the products and service lists. And of course, when we click save and close, or actually we're not clicking save and send, we're clicking save and close. So now when we go back to the sales tax center, you can see we have $62.50 currently accruing that we have not yet paid because this time period is set just showing what's owed as of now, November of 2020. And if you click reports and you custom reports, trial balance, you can see that the cash on hand increased to the $1,250 or increased by that amount and became $1,250 because it was slightly negative. It was negative by like $12.50 before that. And of course, Massachusetts Department of Revenue payable increase. Let's take a look at this payable account. Double click. You can see that only the $62.50 was added on this date from this sale. And if you click reports, trial balance, and you click cash on hand, you see cash was negative by $12.50. And then we added a positive $1,262.50. That explains that number. And of course, sales just shows the gross amount. You double click, it's just going to show you the sale amount of $1,200 and not the tax. So that's the result when you make an item non-taxable. Now let's do example two. Let's imagine that Alan is no longer a taxable client. So how do you handle that? You click sales, you go over to the list of customers, and we'll edit Alan. This is what you do. You click the check mark next to the customer you wish to edit, and then double click their name. When their specific details come up as far as the list of transactions, you then can click edit next to the customer name, and you will get back into the customer information window. The tab to click is tax info, and what you can do is you can click the check mark here. See, I had already checked because I was practicing, but you have it unchecked. So if you click the check mark, this customer is tax exempt. Now, if you want, you can choose one of the reasons why this customer is tax exempt, and you can fill in additional details if this information is not enough. But this little section is extra data. The only important thing is clicking this check mark and click save. Okay, I guess we have to pick a reason it makes us, so we choose other. You could choose whatever reason suits you in this situation, but you have to put some. So I click save. Now we're ready for this transaction. Let's imagine on March 20, we sold two bananas and two apples to Alan. Same idea, but look what happens. When we, does it say cash today? Well, let's assume it's cash today. So two apples and two bananas to Alan. We click new, sale receipt. Be very careful of the date we want back on March 18th of 2020, and the customer is Alan. Now look, we know that bananas are taxable as an item, but notice if we click see the math, nothing happens even though we chose bananas. That's because Alan, the customer, is non-taxable. And of course, apples are already non-taxable, so it doesn't matter. Oh, we have to put two. But it doesn't matter if we click the check mark on both of them. Nothing will be calculated when we click See the Math because this customer is non-taxable. Save and close. And when you look at the reports, you can see that nothing changed in the trial balance from a moment ago. Even though the sales went up and the cash went up, the tax due is the same. Look at the tax section. Nothing changed here. We still owe $62.50 and nothing more because Alan was non-taxable. But look what happens if we reopen that sale receipt and change it to Betty. Look what will happen in the tax center and the trial balance. To find any transaction, we click Reports, open the trial balance. We know that this is a sale receipt, so it's in cash. So we double click, and here's the date, March 18th. Double click. Now, look what happens in the bottom right when we change Alan to Betty. Remember, both items are checked off as taxable, even though only the bananas are taxable. So we're going to change this to Betty Boop and scroll down, and notice the tax automatically changed to $125. Because we know that Betty is taxable, and we know that only the $2,000 of bananas is taxable. And that's why it calculated $125. We click Save and Close. And now when we go to the Tax Center, we can see that for this current period, we only owe $62.50. But if we reset the date range to include all of the taxable transactions and click refresh, now we have a time period showing up here that was past due, as well as this being past due because it's including everything regarding the sales date. You have sales during this period that was due during July, and sales during this period that was due in April, and you have sales in this period that were actually paid. And that's the result when you change taxable to non-taxable for customers or items.